know he's not about me when he's yelling and screaming videos about my allergy one time, woo! Where you wasting, woo? Listen, what Wolfer tells you, 17 titles, Bear Bryant, and Nick freaking Saban, woo!
I guess you've been in the bottle, Luther, and hadn't heard the news. Nick Saban's not coaching, he's got Corona.
What? What do you mean Nick Saban's got Corona virus, woo? Nick Saban cannot have the Corona virus, woo! Nick Saban can't have Corona! What are you looking at, Mantis? Nick Saban cannot have the Corona, woo! Why didn't you do like Luther dudes? Woo? Let me tell you what Luther dudes ain't got no problems in Corona, woo! You gotta drink green alcohol, woo! Luther, nothing can survive in Luther! You hear me, woo? Nothing can survive in here! Why didn't Nick Saban dive in a bottle like not improve for Luther and Bear freaking Bryant? Now woke Todd in it!
I'm going to say this in the nicest way possible to start the video. Y'all are fucking dumb Alabama fans. Y'all are world-class dumb. Yep. Y'all are scared, too. Y'all are nervous. You know, I've been doing this a long time. Tennessee fans last week were more confident than Alabama fans this week. Y'all know what's coming. Y'all know what's coming. Before we get started with the meat and potatoes of the video, though, trivia time. I want to know in the comment section down below, who won this year's Florida State versus Miami game? Let me know down below. All right, Georgia versus Alabama. Well, Alabama ain't got no defense. It's hot doo-doo. That's been confirmed week after week. You give up 450 yards plus a game, 600-something to Ole Miss. I mean, they ran on you. They threw on you. Had two running backs over 100 yards. Every single play, there's two and three wide receivers running wide open down the field. I can't figure it out. Alabama's defense has gotten progressively worse every year since 2016. Now, I don't know what's so magical about 2016, why it would have gotten a little bit worse each year since then. I can't figure it out. Oh, my God, my mind is blown. What could it possibly be? But anyway, this is by far the worst defense you've fielded in a long, long time. It's Swiss cheese. Let's just be honest. Ole Miss shows up with no talent and even less coaching and damn near beat you. Let's be honest. They damn near beat you. You had no answer for them offensively, period. And it's not just an Ole Miss issue. You've struggled defensively now going all the way back to last year. Auburn. Freaking Auburn. My God. Auburn is still scoring points on you from last year's Iron Bowl. Shout out to Mac Jones. Pick six champion of the world. Wow, some of those coming this weekend, too. Oh, we beat Georgia five times in a row. Whippity-doo! Five times in a row. Georgia was better than you in three of those games. Hello? Hello? Is anybody in there? Georgia was better than you in 18, they were better than you in 17, and they were better than you in 2012. You were better in 08 and 15, and we beat you in 07. Congratulations, though, on beating Kirby Smart in his second and then third year ever as a head coach. That's really something to be proud of, Gump. You have the best coach known to man. You had the most talented team in America in both of those years, 17 and 18. And you managed to come behind from a first half ass beating and beat Georgia as a second year head coach in 17 and a third year head coach in 18. Congratulations with the greatest coach in the history of history. A coach that in his second and third year as a Power 5 head coach was busy losing to teams like Indiana and Illinois. And even 10, 15 years after he was a head coach, he was losing while at Alabama to non-Power 5 teams like Utah and Louisiana Monroe. Oh, look at Utah's a Power 5 team, Lou. Not back then, they weren't. Jack, and you got humiliated. I can't relate. My coach has never lost a game to a non-Power 5 team. But Nick Saban's great. Let's give him some credit. He's amazing. Of course, he's on hospice this weekend, isn't he? Yeah, I think he is. In all seriousness, I thought long and hard about it. I'm not going to be making any jokes in this video about coronavirus or Nick Saban having a coronavirus. These videos are fun to do, and I have a lot of fun trash talking with the opposing team's fans every single week. It's not personal to me. Trash talk is just a part of college football. I can't separate it, but I really wish Nick Saban could be there. And maybe he will. I don't know. At the time of me recording this video, there's the whole thing about, you know, him having to have 3 negative tests in a row, and maybe he can show up. And I hope that happens, in all seriousness. I do. Beyond even that, I hope he's going to be okay health-wise. And it seems like he is. I guess he's asymptomatic. So that's good. And I'm sure he's in pretty good shape for a man of his age. So let me just throw that out there. So I'm not going to be making any coronavirus jokes or Nick Saban sick jokes or anything like that. This is a, you know, it can be a deadly virus. And I hope him, the athletic director, and God forbid anybody on the team has it. I haven't heard that they have. And I certainly don't want that to be the case. You know, Georgia's my favorite team, but I'm a college football fan. And when two top 5 teams meet up, like it's about to happen this weekend, I want all the best players to play. So hopefully that's what happens. But now let's get back to you idiot gumps. Getting a little too serious here. That's not what this video is for. Inbred retard. There, that's better. Let me back in the mood now. And damn Gump fans. You dumbasses don't even know what position Forrest Gump played. Y'all are sad, man. That's what happens when you become a fan in 2009. You dipshits were spitting tobacco and watching NASCAR from 1994 to 2008. 2009, you woke up with an Alabama hat on. You're not fooling anybody. This is why y'all are the dumbest fan base in America. You know little to nothing about football. You know Nick Saban, Bear Bryant, and you claim 17 titles, and you know half of them are fake. What kind of a participation award, snowflake, let's make ourselves feel better type shit is it to go around claiming fake natties from 40, 50, and 60 years ago, in years where you lost your bowl game, years where you finished 3rd in the SEC, years where you had 2 and 3 losses? That's fucking sad. That's fucking... And the bad part is, even without all those fake titles that you claim, you'd still have almost more national titles than almost anybody around. So why do it? Well, I know why. You know why, too. Everybody knows why you did that. You did that after Bear Bryant died in 1982, or the end of 82, the beginning of 83. That's when you did it. Up until that point, Alabama never claimed all those fake national titles. But Bear Bryant died. Y'all went around acting like it was a big deal. Oh, poor pitiful me routine. People die, mind blown. And you went back in time then to make yourselves feel better and claimed a whole bunch of fake national titles that never existed up until that point. That's just what, I mean, there's no arguing or debating that. In 1981, Alabama did not claim those fake natties from 40, 50 years prior. All of a sudden in 1983, they start claiming them. Literally right after Bear Bryant wasn't even cold. I mean, the alcohol hadn't even absorbed into his bloodstream. And you guys were claiming those national titles. What a disgrace. What a joke. What a joke. The original We Tried Award. Alabama claiming a bunch of fake natties to make themselves feel better. You ought to be embarrassed and ashamed. And you know, the only thing worse than the University of Alabama going back and claiming those national titles is these idiotic bubblegum gumps who defend it. You can't defend it. If finishing 3rd in the East is a national title, then guess what? Georgia's got more than you! God damn! How many dozens of times have we been the 3rd best team in the East? Hey, let's make some confetti and throw a parade. We finished 3rd in the East. That means we're national champions. Do you see how retarded that sounds? That's you! My God. And why did Bear Bryant die? Well, Georgia killed him. Georgia killed that man. Bear Bryant was running through the SEC, winning conference titles and national titles until hashtag 1980. That's right. Georgia wins the SEC and the national title in 1980. They go on to repeat as SEC champions in 81, losing the national title game. And they go on to three-peat as SEC champions in 1982, again, losing the national championship game. But they won the SEC 3 years in a row, 80, 81, and 82. Bear Bryant put his liquor bottle down, slapped his wife, and said to himself, "I just don't have it anymore." And he retired at the end of the 1982 season. And 6 weeks later, he was dead. Georgia killed him. Georgia killed him. Nick Saban ain't no spring chicken either. And guess who's going to put him out to pasture? The University of Georgia. The college football world owes the University of Georgia a huge thank you for getting rid of the plague known as Bear Bryant in the early 80s. And now they can throw another round of applause our way when we put this dinosaur Nick Saban out to pasture too. His time is up. Georgia has passed him by talent-wise, and Kirby's at the point now where he ain't about to get out-coached by this jamoke in the second half of any more games, and you're going to find that out tomorrow, aren't you, Gump? Huh? You going to find that out tomorrow? Yeah, you are. You are. Oh, you can't stop our offense, Lou. Have you watched any football this year? That's a rhetorical question. Most of you don't have TVs or cable or internet. Georgia's defense is for real. Now, that being said, you'll score some points. We're not going to shut you out. You'll score some points. Hell, you might even score about half your average. What would that be, 24? You might get 24. You might get to 27. You ain't getting to 30, and that's the magic number in this game. Oh, Lou. Look at Lou talking about Alabama. Georgia ain't got no offense. Look at him. Look at him. He must not know. Somebody tell Lou Georgia ain't got no offense. Georgia ain't got no offense. Again. You don't watch football, and even if you do, you wouldn't know what you were looking at because you're football ignorant. Georgia's averaging 37 points a game. Last year, we averaged 19 points a game. Last year, we had no offense. Ooh. This year, 37 points a game. Oh, big deal. We're averaging 50. I know, but Georgia's only giving up 12! 12 points a game. We're giving up. Hell, we haven't given up a rushing touchdown to a running back since 2018. Najee will probably get one if y'all can get in the red zone. That dude can't get a touchdown outside the red zone to save his life. I think he finally had one against Ole Miss. First one he's had in his career. Up until that Ole Miss game, every single running touchdown Najee Harris had ever had come from within the red zone. My God. No explosive plays from that dud. Oh, I can't forget about Mac Jones. Mac Jones is lighting it up. Look at his numbers. Yeah, his numbers are amazing against Ole Miss, Mizzou, Texas A&M. Three perennial winners in the SEC, ain't they? My God. What happened the last time Mac Jones played a decent defense? Auburn last year. He's still, like I said, he's still throwing pick sixes. Shoot. Y'all was ready to revoke his scholarship after that Auburn game, were you? You better ask yourself a serious question. Who's got a better defense? Auburn 2019 or Georgia 2020? Please tell me even you Gumps realize that Georgia's defense is better than Auburn's was last. Please tell me you realize that. Yeah, Mac Jones can't move. His feet don't work. He's got cinder blocks for feet. The guy can't run, and that's not good. You should know. You should know, Alabama fan. A Nick Saban or a Kirby Smart defense can struggle at times against a mobile QB. Lucky for Georgia, you ain't got one. And we do! That's right! Stetson Bennett! Probably the best quarterback in the SEC is Stetson Bennett. This walk-on. What a huge improvement over Jack Frohm this guy is, this Stetson Bennett. Thank God. Why didn't he play last year? Man, thank God Frohm is gone. Frohm was like Mac Jones. I mean, the guy couldn't move from here to there. I've walked more yards back and forth in this room during the course of this video than Frohm or Mac Jones will do in their entire career running the ball. But not Stetson Bennett. Yep. A walk-on. You're fixing to get humiliated by a three-star walk-on that had zero scholarship offers out of high school. That's what's about to happen. That's what's about to happen. All these jokes about Georgia's quarterback situation and running off five-star talent, and we're fixing to line up, bend you over, and push your shit right up into your own asshole with a three-star walk-on who's 5 foot nothing, 100 nothing, to quote a famous line from Rudy. Stetson, of course, way better than Rudy. Way better than Rudy. First of all, Rudy was like a ninth string defensive end who played two plays, if you count the kickoff, out of pity. That's the only reason he played. The entire team threatened to quit. They didn't at least let him dress out for the game. So they were winning at the end, and they put Rudy Rudiger in for one play. Stetson Bennett's out here winning games. He's undefeated. He's got a better winning percentage than Mac Jones. Man, Stetson Bennett is fixing to humiliate you. You know it's true. You haven't beat us in Tuscaloosa since 1994. Oh, we don't play every year. Well, whoopity-doo. Whoopity-doo. I can't wait for this game. I can't wait. Because I know Georgia's going to win. Because Georgia's just a better team. Everybody knows Georgia's a better team. Even the people picking Georgia to lose aren't picking Georgia to lose because Alabama's a better team. You're not a better team. God damn. Anybody with a set of working eyes and an iota of football knowledge knows that. If anybody's picking Georgia to lose, it's because of the mental thing of not being able to beat Nick Saban. Well, that's out the window, Jack. Hard to explain that. Nick Saban's going down. Then you morons can run around talking about how he's 22-1 or whatever it is against former assistants or whatever the hell. Boy, y'all make us some dumbass, meaningless, pointless stats, don't you? God darn. What is it, 22-1, 22? Why don't you just say 50-1? Just make it up like you do national titles. Nick Saban's 142-0 against former assistants. Well, 142-1 coming up this weekend, dumbass gumps. Swear to God. And Forrest Gump's a terrible fucking movie, too. These Alabama fans who go around beating their chest about how great of a movie Forrest Gump. Y'all are brain dead, aren't you? You have to be. Forrest Gump's a dry-ass, dusty movie about nothing. Find somebody that's never seen Forrest Gump and try to explain it to them in 30 seconds or less. That's your homework assignment. You can't. If someone's never seen Forrest Gump, the only way to explain it to them is to say, well, you just got to watch it. But then, I mean, that's punishment, having to watch that dry movie. Well, nobody cares about that movie. A movie about nothing. Nothing at all. Idiot Alabama fans. The greatest player Alabama's ever had was Forrest Gump. They don't know what position he played. They don't know what year he graduated. They don't know who the coach was. I mean, they know nothing. They don't know shit. They know Bear Bryant, Nick Saban, them team titles. Yeah, any point you bring up to that, oh yeah, well what about Bear Bryant, Nick Saban 17 title? Hey Gump, what about Dylan Moses is the worst linebacker in the SEC? Yeah, but what about Nick Saban, Bear Bryant 17 titles, Dodo? What about that, Dodo? Hey Gump, Patrick Surtain or whatever the hell his name is, might be the best corner in football. But guess what, Gump? He can only cover one player per play, and the rest of your secondary is gutter juice. Oh, yeah, Lou? You take that back right now, Lou. What about Nick Bryant, Sarah Babin, and Title Teen 7? That's literally what you sound like. That's literally what you sound like. How can nobody in your defense tackle? How did that happen? I seriously have to know. I seriously have to know. It can't just be purely a talent issue. I mean, God almighty, y'all look like Oklahoma from 2017 out there. It's bad. Out of position, can't wrap up. The Ole Miss players running through you. Two different running backs for Ole Miss over 100. My God. Y'all know you're losing. You know you're losing. Here's what you do. You better do the 2017 deal is what you should do. Where you try to back in because you don't want these problems again in December in the SEC title game. You better figure out some kind of way to not win the West and backdoor into the playoff or whatever like you did in 17. Hell, you ain't won your division but once in the last 3 years, so it shouldn't be that hard for you not to make it to the SEC title game. You're getting pretty good at it. You're getting pretty good at it. One division title in 3 years. Wow. Oh, my God. That's amazing. That's amazing. You've got the same number of division titles in the last 3 years as the Miami Hurricanes do. Congratulations. You've got the same number of division titles in the last 3 years as Pitt. Congratulations. You've got the same number of division titles in the last 3 years as Alabama. Greenbow, Alabama! Talking about Greenbow, Lou. Forrest Gump's from Greenbow. He played for Bear Bryant, Nick Saban, 17 titles. Yeah, well, I can't wait for you idiots to go back to watching NASCAR or whatever the hell it is y'all were doing before you suddenly became Alabama fans in 2009, because this merry-go-round ride you guys have been on for the last 12 years is coming to a screeching halt on Saturday, ain't it? Yeah, it is. It is. It is. We euthanized Bear Bryant. Nick Saban is next. He's on his last leg. That's just what it is. Kirby Smart's taking over the SEC and all the college football for that matter. And the best thing Nick Saban can do is get the fuck out of the way. He's nothing more than a speed bump. And if he's not careful, he's going to end up a greasy stain on the pavement somewhere with a Kirby Smart tire track up over the back of his head. If you run over Nick Saban, they don't charge you with nothing. You can't see him. How are you supposed to see him? I'm surprised he ain't got ran over already, crossing the road or something. You can't see that guy. You seen those statues at Bear Bryant Stadium? They got all the statues of all the coaches that have won national titles outside of Bear Bryant Stadium. Outside of Alabama Stadium. So they got like the statue of Bear Bryant and whoever the hell else won those titles. And then they got the statue of Nick Saban. It's like half the size of the other statue. They had to make the pedestal on the Nick Saban statue like 6 feet tall. it looks like one of those lollipop people from Wizard of Oz, doesn't he? Yeah, he does. World's tallest midget, Nick Saban. Don't worry, he's on his way out. He's headed off to Shady Pines or whatever retirement home he's gonna rot away in. We all know that. Anyway, big game tomorrow, night game, 8 o'clock. You get to show off your dollar store light show that you tried to copy from UGA, but you did a piss poor job. It looks absolutely ridiculous. Georgia had it first. You had it 3-4 weeks later, whatever it was, and what a disappointment it was, too. It looks ridiculous. It looks ridiculous. The Bryant-Denny Stadium's light show is the... because everybody's doing it now. But the Bryant-Denny Stadium light show that they do at night is the Griswold family Christmas of college football light shows. You know, you guys talked about that light show all summer last year like anybody gave a fuck, which they didn't. And then it comes time to turn that thing on and, oh my God, nothing. Nothing. Y'all need to rewire it. Take that thing down and start over. That's an embarrassment. That's an absolute embarrassment. It's a damn joke. That light show. Yeah, night game. I guess y'all excited about that. Nick Saban won't have to come out and complain about what time the games are being played. What was that about last year? Every time you turned around last year, Nick Saban was on ESPN crying about what time their games were at. Or crying because the students wouldn't stay for the whole game. This Nick Saban. What a crybaby, man. Thank God for Dabo Swinney, right? Nick Saban owes Dabo Swinney something. I don't know what, but he owes him something. Because Dabo Swinney's the biggest crybaby in all of college football, and he takes a lot of that negative attention away from Saban. But if it wasn't for Dabo Swinney, Nick Saban would be the king of crying in college football. His press conference has got to be sponsored by Kleenex. Are they? Somebody let me know. Anyway, thanks for typing in the comment section down below that Miami beat Florida State. I asked you at the beginning of the video who won that game. Thanks for letting me know that Miami beat Florida State. Now you're going to go edit your comment or delete it. But that's all you put. When I asked you to type down below who won that game, that's all you put. You put Miami beat Florida State or Florida State lost to Miami. That's all you put. You didn't put Miami lost to Florida State, but Florida State didn't have them head coach, woo. Nope, you didn't put that, did you? No, you didn't. You didn't. So we don't want to be seeing that dumb shit on Sunday either. So Nick Saban, make you a ham sandwich or two. Get some golden flakes or whatever the hell it is that Bear Bryant used to eat. You can stay home Saturday, slap your wife around in honor of Bear Bryant. We're going to go out there and slap the gumps around. That's what's going to happen. Alabama ought not even show up for this game, should they? No, they shouldn't. Something tells me they will, though. Alabama football team, they're gluttons for punishment, the gumps. Hell, they're still licking their wounds from the Ole Miss game. Anyway. Hey, my dogs is doing some traveling this weekend. Did you know that? That's right. My dogs are headed west to T-Town. Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Yeah, I'm going to play a football game. If Alabama wants to show up, open invitation. Bryant Denny Stadium, we're going to come into your own house and beat you. But I tell you what, Gumps, on your way to the stadium Saturday night, Bryant Denny, do me a favor. Stop by Nick Saban's house. He'll be there. And drop off some chicken soup for his soul. He's going to need it because Georgia's going to take him. Georgia's coming to Bryant Denny Stadium Saturday night, and they're leaving with a W. They're going to beat you so bad, your own sister won't want to fuck you. Now, if that sounds like something you're into, Gump, I tell you what you can do. Come get you some of this, bitch!